Do you know what glassware gets a title right after coming out of the factory? Wrong. It's the graduated cylinder. Okay, it's probably a lame pun to start a topic, but the cylinder we talk about is not lame at all. It's been used by learners all over the world for decades and helps scientists and non-scientists do science and general volume measuring. A graduated cylinder or measuring cylinder is a tube-shaped tool made of glass or plastic with a base for stability. It has scales in milliliters or cubic centimeters to measure volume precisely. For liquid, simply pour the substance into the cylinder and properly read the measurement at the scale. The ingenious use of the cylinder is probably in measuring the volume of irregular-shaped solids that may otherwise be difficult to calculate using the standard formula, such as a T-Rex's metacarpal. Suppose we have a 100 ml measuring cylinder. Make sure that we put it on a flat surface for proper scale reading. First, fill the cylinder partially with water and record the volume. Then submerge the T-Rex's metacarpal in the water and observe how the water level rises. The difference between the new and original volumes is the object's volume. For example, if the water level rises from 25 ml to 47 ml when the T-Rex bone is added, the bone's volume is 22 ml. This measurement method is called the displacement method, where volume of an object is determined from the amount of liquid displaced by the object as it is immersed into that liquid. This method was famously used by Archimedes to prove the purity of a gold crown, although without a measuring cylinder. Knowing that silver is about half as dense as gold, he deduced that the water displaced by silver would be twice that of gold. As he immersed the crown into water, he observed that it displaced more water than pure gold does, but less than silver, indicating that it was a mixture rather than pure gold. But how do we measure the volume of floating objects like a rubber duck? All you need is a metal lump. First, mark the volume of the metal alone in the water. Then, mark the volume of the duck with the metal attached and subtract the two volumes to find the rubber duck's volume. To measure the volume of irregular solids larger than the measuring cylinder, use the displacement can. Fill the can to the spout with water and position a beaker glass beneath it. Immerse the solid into the water, causing it to overflow into the beaker. The volume of the overflowed water is equal to the volume of the solid. Now pour the water from the beaker into a measuring cylinder for accuracy. One important thing in measurement is to ensure that the scale is read exactly at the eye level to avoid reading errors due to the incorrect eye positioning. Additionally, the meniscus, the curved surface of liquid in a container, should be taken into account when reading the scale. For liquid, the scale should be read on the bottom of the meniscus, while for mercury, with a convex meniscus, it should be read at the top. Now, here is a tricky question for you. Do you think the measuring cylinder can also be used to measure the volume of gas? Share your thoughts below.